So open initially it refers to learning not confined to the campus. Example is the University of London external program. And learners may or may not interact face-to-face with teachers. Any encounter may be in learning centers or locations close or convenient to the learners. But increasingly, class contacts are conducted online rather than physical, face-to-face. Contact time is always much less. The educational resources is actually the main part of the cost of running open university. That is the academic time is mostly involved in developing teaching materials. Open is open to all learners who may not possess the conventional entry qualification. The student may not have a high school certificate to enter a normal university. Open as in flexibility or open-ended completion time for a program of study. The learner may interrupt the study periods and while earned credits will be on hold and you can resume anytime. Lastly, the open adult and lifelong learning. So there is no restriction on the age of learners. Learners almost invariably undertake a full or part of the program without putting their job on hold. So target audience at the moment, the current participants of open education, mainly are the working population. Right? School leavers form a very tiny proportion at this moment. Open learners in general are working people looking for upgrade of their skill and qualification. That is at this moment. Many conventional jobs are disappearing. Up to half the worst job, around 2 billion, are at high risk of disappearing due to automation in the coming decades. Social disruption result when large number of young people without work leading to turmoil, right? For the developing world, there is no effective long-term countermeasure except higher level education and upgrading of skills. Open education has a great potential to impact and to change society. Its geographical reach of the target audience and headcount capacity far higher compared to conventional university. The UN came out with the fresh set called the Agenda 2030. For sustainable development. So the agenda has a set of 17 sustainable development goals or SDGs to cover this period, 2015 to 2030. You can see education is a main factor that in this sustainable development goals. So the SDG 4 is referred to as Education 2030. And they simply state, the statement is very simple, clear, to ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. There is a framework accompanying the declaration. There's a framework which spells out the detail, a roadmap on how to achieve this development goal. SDG 4. The new skill will be heavily built on STEM, and so it highlights that the need to focus on STEM. Employability at the moment is normally not of high concern because most of the student is already working people. So they are not fresh graduate looking for job. So because of that, employability is already employed. So these are people looking to upgrade the skills and gaining new competencies. However, employer recognition of the new gain qualification is important. Right. A problem faced by open education is perceived low academic reputation generally, although this is not universally the case. External degrees from the University of London and UK Open University are very well regarded internationally. Right. However, this highly regarded open education institution is hardly accessible by a great number of those in the developing world who are the most in need of the credential. The action framework urges common ground for cross-border accreditation of skills and qualifications, issues of comparability, recognition, and quality assurance of qualifications are to be dealt with. So it's still something that need a lot of work to improve the academic status as perceived by employers. For open education institution in the developing world, strategic partnering. So that's what I think that strategic partnering may help. The students should be allowed to and encouraged to take some subject unit credits of a program of study via the MOOC or similar courses from outside institution or industry partners with noted expertise in those subject areas. Employers ought to give due credit to open education qualifications. Open education program demands much greater determination of the participants to persevere successfully to completion. It will reduce the cost of running an open university if we share the teaching material, because you need a lot of effort for the academics to develop the material, to update and upgrade continually. They are continually upgraded and updated, so this will reduce the cost. This is another part other than the academic quality, which I consider is a major challenge for open university. Right, another problem open education is the low completion rate and high dropout rate. There are several reasons for this, of course. Lack of motivation is one. After the initial period following embarking on an open education program or study, learners often lost interest and when there's no motivation to inspire them. This is especially so when they are faced with heavy demand of their time and their full-time work or family situation. I consider this is the main role of a good teacher, to inspire. Good student, once they are inspired, they can learn themselves. You don't have to teach. They can get the material, they can go to the web, go to the library, they can learn. So it's the inspiring that does the work of getting students to learn. Technology has helped them to mitigate the lack of face-to-face contact between teachers and learners. Now it's up to the teachers now how to use their ingenuity to provide the inspiration and motivation. So this is, we have to leave it to the education needs. train the teachers to provide this part. I think this is the most difficult part. Issue of internet access still have problem. Technology required for effective open education depends on the telecommunications infrastructure and penetration of internet. Employers' role can also make a difference to the learners. As a majority of open education learners hold full-time job, roping in their employers will help student retention. The least employers can do is to help include incentives for progress as an employee gains competency credits in areas relevant to their job. Internet access, time off, and space for employees to attend online classes at their workplace will be helpful. At the moment, a small number of school leavers who take up open education study on a full-time basis. This is a reversal of the normal open university where the learner work full-time and study part-time. Open education learners do not need to leave home to attend university. So this will save on living and travel costs. They can study at home. Open university qualifications are accredited by national bodies and are officially treated as full equivalent of qualification earned from conventional universities. Its geographical reach is without bound and enrollment number has no limit practically. And these advantages put open education way beyond the capacity of conventional university in realizing equitable access for big number of learners in developing world. So it called for ODA, including commitment by many developed countries to achieve 0.7% of the GNI. And for the developing countries, 0.7%, and for the least developed countries, 0.15 to 0.2 of GNI to the least, given to the least, to help the least developed countries. So this is a call for the developed countries to help to spread and upgrade the world. So Singapore's position, I just look at the situation in Singapore. It's the leading education center in Asia, in fact, the world. I know it has the advantage of using English for teaching. English is the language widely used in universities in many different countries. Singapore's geographical location is right in the middle of this region, which has about 30% of the world's population. To sum up the opportunity, we have the means, that is open education, to bring about change to the world. The challenges, which to sum up what we have discussed, academic quality to give employability internationally. So we have to a lot of work required on that. Use of OER and MOC require standardization of curriculum and credit rating of courses. Teachers and technologies require to motivate and inspire to improve retention and bring up the completion rate. And lastly, leadership and financing for implementing what has been set up.